We'll just be unkind to it here.
Stop. I'm trying to screw with you. Stop.
I'm screwing with you.
As I get older, there's one thing that I want my 3D printers to do. Work. And you think that's pretty easy, but it really is not. And apparently AnchorMake has made one that uses the power of AI to prevent spaghetti. Let's test it out. And huge thanks to AnchorMake for sponsoring this video. Ugh. I've been using 3D printers for the better part of 10 years. And for about 5 of those, I didn't use 3D printers because they're so good at being just terrible. For a long while there, I only liked using laser cutters because then at least if it fails, you only waste an hour or two instead of a day. When you're working on videos like this, you can't waste a day. Ugh. In the last couple of years though, 3D printers have gotten to the point where, well, I enjoy using them again. They work well, they give me my parts, and I just arrive the next day and it's sitting there, it's fantastic. Hopefully this one can do that and even better. And apparently faster too. Although their 70% claims are kinda. Oh, fancy. Look at this. Apparently this thing only takes 15 minutes to put together. Guess we're gonna find out soon. I'm running out of table. I like the packaging. It seems like the whole thing arrived intact despite, you know, UPS's best efforts. This plate right here looks really expensive. This is all aluminum. I don't know if it's hollow or not. Can we take it apart? Let's take it apart. We're supposed to be putting it together, but you know, sometimes things just start going the wrong way. Have an included toolkit, very nice. Oh, weird. Look at this, it's a changeable Allen key.
Should we do this after we test it?
We'll see how difficult it is. Okay, bottom's plastic, that's good. I don't know the price yet, so I'm mostly just looking at this and hoping it's not too bad. Normally you don't compliment people on using plastic, but if this whole thing was aluminum, I would have been pretty concerned about the pricing. It's just injection molded plastic. The top though is a piece of aluminum. I wonder what the chances are. Heck yeah. Did we do it? Feels like there's a sneaky screw somewhere. Do you know how many units there are in existence right now, Jono?
Probably very little.
Yeah, very few. I know that this is all beta build stuff. So how many exist right now? We don't know, but it can't be very many, so we probably shouldn't break it. Found the last screw required to get this open. It requires a 16th inch hex. This right here does not reach all the way down.
They knew what they were doing.
Yeah, they probably don't want us in here. Which, like, fair enough, we're gonna be right beside AC. Haha. Damn, Frig Jono, this is gonna be expensive. There's no way this is cheap. That's a very nice and very expensive block of aluminum right there. 1.5, 1.5. Would have had to come out of like a 3-inch thick piece of aluminum. This has to be a beta version thing. This would either have to be cast or plastic in the final one. There's no way they're doing something this expensive or it's gonna be like a $5,000 machine. $429, okay, yeah, there's no way that this right here is the part on the final version. If the early bird price is, and that's what, like a bit off, so that means the final is gonna come around 800-ish?
Probably, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, there's no way this part's on there. This is a really nice part. Our Pantheon printer has a very similar like build plate that they put everything against.
And that's about $2,000 to $3,000.
That's $8,000. If the product is this and it comes in at $429, you should just buy it and take the aluminum. All right, now we can have a look at what's in here. We have a nice little power supply here, 24 volts. Oh, Jono. Looks like we can change the output voltage. Should we try and overclock this thing?
No, maybe later.
That wouldn't work. Don't do that. We also have our nice little controller. I find it really interesting that they use type C. All right, we just got it confirmed from Anchor. This aluminum bit here is going to be cast in the final product, but it will be all aluminum, which is sweet. Do we read the instructions, Jono, or do we just go for it?
YOLO.
Yeah, this seems very YOLO-able. There's probably a good way to do this. This one has a bent pin.
You bent the pin?
No, I didn't bend the pin. It came with a bent pin. Oops, now it's more bent. Is there like a way you're supposed to do this?
Yes.
How? I was definitely supposed to plug in those motors after it was through, which would have made this way easier. Read the instructions. Don't be like me.
But you're so cool.
Yeah, actually, don't read the instructions. Make sure the first thing you do with every product that you own is void the warranty. Yeah, I know people that kept the warranty on their things. They're all dead now. Oh yeah, that would make it way easier. Yeah, if you look at it. Yeah, it would just hold it kind of like I have it right now. Actually, we can still do that. Okay, Jono, can you put the foam under it? you had it right the first time, I think.
I think it was this way. There you go.
Yep, okay, that's easy. What are these four bolts for? It's for the filament holder. Oh, that's a filament holder. This makes so much sense. I was so confused what this thing was. Yeah, so it goes here or here. I found a pre-production thing, Jono. The screw don't go through.
Oh no!
I think it's safe to say you won't have to do this step. Okay, yeah, maybe safety glasses are a good idea, Jono. All right, we did it. All right, now we can attach this. I love pre-production things. They're always so much more fun. Back to the filament holder though. This little one that they gave us, clearly no problem. Now we have our regular sized roll here and that fits pretty much perfectly. Although if you're going for the mega roll, yeah, not so much. I don't really expect it to be able to hold something like this. It weighs about as much as the printer. If you want a big roll, you're gonna have to buy one of the $20 Amazon roll holder thingies. Hey, Jono, can you ask them how they do their leveling? They have 49 points of auto leveling, which is awesome. It makes your prints just work so much more of the time. So, you know, if your bed isn't quite correct, then maybe on one side, your first layer doesn't stick and then it doesn't really work. First layer is kind of all that matters. Once you get that, everything else is good. There's two ways to do auto leveling though. You can either have like a capacitive touch probe, which is pretty good, but now a lot of them are using strain gauges, which is even better. I think we're about ready to boot this up though. Is it on? It is. Okay, let's have a little look at the control that we have here. So if I hit home, where does it go? There, I guess. I'm not entirely sure how I feel about having the controller on the Z-axis. It is going to be moving, but it shouldn't be moving very much while it prints. Level before printing, turn that on. Oh, nice. So it is using the actual extruder. I'm not quite sure how they're doing it. Okay, we're doing the auto leveling now. I guess just had to heat up first. It takes a little while to do it, but I would still just leave it on for every single time that I run a print. It's just cheap insurance. That means that it'll work more of the time. Okay, let's see. Cut the end of the filament on a 45 degree angle. Now we're just gonna put it in here and hopefully, I was kind of hoping that we could get a print started using what's here. And oh, I got it through. Yeah, that's just kind of not great. I had a little bit of trouble getting the filament to go down to the extruder. All that I did to fix it was take off this little clip. You can pull this tube out and then look down in and feed the filament down.
Hey, all right. So what I'm doing is just connecting the 3D printer with the AnchorMate with the app. What should we call this? Coopsmith.
Sure. I was gonna say Printy Boy number 5, but
I like that. That's better. All right, Printy Boy 5. Cool. So we just want to make sure that this has all the, you know, latest up, you know, firmware. That's cool. You can actually like have files on your smartphone. You can upload it from there.
You're taking too long. I already have G-code on here.
Oh, okay, fine. You can control it.
I love that they have their speed as 5 times, even though it's just 250 millimeters per second. Which by the way, 250 millimeters per second, very fast. That is awesome. I just find it silly how they did it. So I wonder what this is. Let's just go, see what happens. Oh, one thing. Savage. Oh yeah.
Oh, you have to auto level again?
You don't have to, but I turn on auto leveling every time just because it makes your prints more consistent. If this just works, I'm going to be pretty impressed. I have done literally none of the things that you should probably do with a 3D printer, like not even an alcohol wipe. We definitely should have done that, but whatever. If this just goes, then fantastic. What do you guys think this is? We're just putting mystery G-code into this, which I do not recommend, but it's from Anker, so I'm sure it's fine. Okay, do they do a little extrude thing at the start? Nope. That's really fast for a first layer. I'd probably turn it down a bit, but I guess that's what it's doing. First layer is almost done, but I am impressed with the speed. Especially for just out of the box, this is looking promising. Let's come back in, I don't know, an hour or something. All right, it's the next day, and I have to say, I'm very impressed. This print took 2 hours and 24 minutes, tells you right there. And this is, comes off very easy. I was afraid that would be a bit of a challenge, but it wasn't. This is, like, look at this. There's barely any stringing between these guys. There's like a tiny bit, but there's just a bunch of super challenging things in here. So like a ramp that just goes up to a 15 degree angle. It gets a little bit weird here, but if you ever used a 3D printer before, you know that this is not easy to do. We've got a bunch of weird little overhangs in here and a whole bunch of little dimensions. So let's check it out. Something like this ramp is challenging because we aren't using support. So that means that it kind of just has to print it and keep on going and have all the layers stick properly so it can do this overhang, because it is just going up and up and up. So there's nothing supporting it underneath here. Same with these little spires are very difficult because of the filament, you know, it's very easy for even when it stops for a little bit to just keep on coming out. And then when it goes between them, you get those little bits of filament in between it. So like if this printer wasn't working very well, it would get a whole bunch of stringing in between these and it would just kind of look like a nest as opposed to a whole bunch of little spires. I think that what this is it's a cylinder and a hole of different sizes. So this is 0.5, is that half a millimeter? You can see it's a cylinder that comes out of the hole.
What? What? They can 3D print that?
Yeah, and so this one's 0.3, that one comes out. Okay, for whatever reason, 0.4 comes after 0.3, but sure, that one comes out too. They need to figure out how they're doing it, but 0.2 of a millimeter, that one's not coming out. Okay, it looks like each of these are 10 millimeter increments. The way that it's printed, it's kind of hard to tell exactly how accurate it is. Like I can show it as 10 on here, but it might be a little bit off. 24.9, I'm sure that was supposed to be 25. Very good. It's off by this much in a lot of cases.
Why is it off?
What, that's barely off, Jono. If you want your stuff to be within a thousandth of an inch, then
pay a professional.
Yeah, pay 10 times more. Well, there's a number of other cool things that we have here. Jono, do you want to bring over the app? We have a video feed of your print. Hello, myself, over the internet. What? Okay, I guess, oh, balls. Yep, I broke it. Start this one again, print.
Oh, cool.
And it starts. Speed, boom, 6 times. Sure, save.
Wow. How fast is that?
300 millimeters per second. That's to the point where you're going to run into extruder issues unless you have things really dialed in. Like just how fast you can move the plastic out and stop the plastic becomes a problem when you're going that fast. Now there are a lot of things that we don't know about this printer. The biggest big question mark is the slicer. Anker Maker are going to have their own slicer and it's probably fine. It probably has a great profile for this printer, but how good it actually is and how powerful it is, we don't know yet. A slicer is what takes your 3D model. Like say we had a 3D model of this. It converts it into the 0.4 millimeter or whatever layers going all the way up and turns into the code that the machine runs.
You can make coffee too.
It doesn't make coffee, unfortunately. You could definitely write G-code to make you coffee. I don't know if you could do it in a slicer. And the main test I want to do here, once it's done doing its auto-leveling, is just try and screw with it a bit and see if it can ping Jono's phone when it screws up. I should try and screw with it. I'm gonna take a spire and just put it in here. Maybe it'll run it over. Ah, no, it's knocked out of the way. Darn. We'll just be unkind to it here.
Wow, really?
Yeah, stop. I'm trying to screw with you. Stop.
It's screwing with you.
Hey. Okay, I know what we can do here. Stop working.
Let me
just clip it. Oh yeah, I could just clip it. I'm sorry, Mr. Printer. Will it realize? Yeah, it seems like it still is printing. It's supposed to stop. I wonder if it stops, if it detects it in here.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay, that makes a lot more sense.
It did say it paused.
Yeah, it does make sense that they would have the filament detection over here, because then you would still have plenty of time to, you know, take it out, swap the spool, put it back in, and not have to worry about your print getting all screwed up. Overall though, especially for the price, I'm quite impressed. Right now there's a Kickstarter on where this is 43% off, so that's $430. For that price, I think it's a very easy buy. At the usual price of $760, still very great. Like, this was incredibly easy to set up. It seems to print well. It has lots of features that allow you to easily print from just your phone and stuff. I'm actually impressed. And thank you, AnchorMake, for sponsoring this video and also for making a good product, because then it's not awkward that you sponsored it. We like honesty here. So hit like, get subscribed, and if you want more makery type videos, let us know. See you later.